two firmness options instead of just one. Now, we did take a look at the Layla mattress about 6 months ago, and you can see they've done a lot in terms of changing their branding. Now, for starters, the purple color scheme on the box has been changed to a combination of orange, gray, and green, and the voice of the company in general has transitioned from a sleep focus to one of encouragement to be a better person when you are awake. Now, you even get a goodie bag in your box. It's filled with a drawstring bag with wrapper opener, double unboxing, brochures, stickers, and even this t-shirt. So let's take a look at some of the other changes you can expect and how this product worked out. To give you an idea of how this mattress works, we're going to take a look at what's inside. The main change of the new Layla mattress is the cover. It's now double-sided, so you don't have to remove it and flip when you switch the mattress. They also changed their cube design to a hexagonal one, giving the Layla mattress a more modern look. Now, I love that you can clearly distinguish soft from firm. Now, inside the cover are four foam layers. We see the same lineup and composition as what we experienced with the old version of the same mattress, starting on the plush setting with 3 inches of copper-infused memory foam. This layer is geared toward keeping your mattress clean and cool. It also offers comforting contour. Now, I think those who don't really carry a whole lot of weight are going to appreciate the thicker memory foam comfort layer, since it can be difficult to really enjoy that lumbar support when back sleeping on firmer products. Now, layer 2 is composed of 2 inches of convoluted airflow foam. The grooves allow for an easier escape for otherwise trapped heat. The primary base layer that serves both the soft and firm settings is made up of 4.5 inches of base support foam. It works to keep motion transfer at bay, and we'll demonstrate its effectiveness here in a moment. Now, finally, we end off with another inch of memory foam. When we flip this around, we get a look at the firm option. Now, you still benefit from memory foam, but there is 66% less of it than with the plush setting, much more direct contact with the firmer base layer. Let's talk for just a moment about what this layer lineup feels like. Now, I love the softness of the cover. It almost feels silky, and this has to do with the softening process that Layla uses on their fabrics. Regardless of the firmness you choose, you can feel the firmer structural support provided by the copper and the memory foam, and this really helps a lot in keeping you aligned. You see, as copper compresses, it strengthens, and this makes for excellent support for areas prone to pressure points like the hips and shoulders. Now, when your hips and shoulders are properly supported, this automatically works to keep your spine aligned, and Layla calls this variable support. It works to keep stomach, back, and sides super comfortable. Now, we know there are two firmness options, so let's take a look at each one and see a little more specifically where on the spectrum each one falls. Again, nothing has changed with this layer lineup in terms of orientation and reflection from what we saw the previous time we tried this product out. This is a measurement that helps us gauge firmness, and I'll leave a link in the description below to explain just how it works. Just know that 12 is very soft and 50 is very firm. On the plush setting, we find an ILD of 10 in the memory foam, followed by an increase to 30 in the convoluted foam. The base is firmer with an ILD of 36, and the final memory foam layer matches the top with an ILD of 10. To give you a visual, I stood in the middle of the mattress on both the firm and soft settings and measured sinkage. A standard medium will typically sink 6.5 inches. The soft side of the Layla mattress sinks in 7.25 inch, so this is very typical of a medium soft. Flipping over to the firm setting, we see a sinkage of 5.5 inches, which is pretty firm. Now, if you Google our new Layla topper review, you can see how it opens up 2 more options, allowing for a total of 4 firmness possibilities. Now, on a single sleep unit, I think this shows once again the efforts Layla has put into accommodating a wide array of sleepers. Body temperature is quite a bit higher than comfortable room temperature, so when your mattress absorbs heat and can't distribute it properly, it can be difficult to enter REM sleep. I'll leave a link in the description below if you want to learn more about the science of how that works. But to put heat transfer to the test, I lie on the mattress for a half hour and monitor the cool-down process. The plush side took 13.5 minutes, while the firm side took right around 13 minutes. Although this is higher than average, I think it's pretty good considering nearly 40% of the layers are memory foam. The fact that the soft side with a thicker memory foam took just a little bit longer further contributes to this theory. Layla took 3 measures to keep heat buildup minimal. If you don't typically have issues with hot sleeping, I don't think that you're going to have anything to worry about. However, those who do may want to check out some of our latex mattresses at thesleepjudge.com. In the cover, ThermoGel is woven into the material. It's a cooling agent that helps you sleep cool. The very tiny copper particles infused in the memory foam work to pull excess body heat away from the mattress surface. Finally, the convoluted foam has grooves that allow for easy airflow. So yes, it did take a little bit longer to cool off, but you do get to enjoy that more traditional memory foam feel. Edge support helps keep you supported when you sit or lie on the edge, and it can also help to get you in and out of bed more easily. In many foam products, edge support is lacking, but the Layla mattress does do a pretty good job. Now, like most foam mattresses,